إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إمام الترمذي رحمه الله تعالى mentions in his Sunan the famous hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما. He said, كنت خلف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما, that one day I was riding behind the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this was the method of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his companions when he wanted to teach them about al-Islam. And it shows you how humble he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he was riding on his mount and sitting behind him was a young child known as Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. So he said, كنت خلف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما, that one day I was sitting behind the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, يا غلام إني أعلمك بكلمات. Oh young boy, oh young child, indeed I am going to teach you some words. Oh young child, indeed I am going to teach you some words. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم then teaches Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma words that if he holds on to, Jannah will be his. If he holds on to, that he will be protected by Allah in this life and the next. If he holds on to, that he will only ask Allah and only rely upon Allah and only depend on Allah, and nothing can come between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاهك, that guard Allah, meaning guard the boundaries that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will guard you. Guard the boundaries that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will guard you. This has a greater meaning than following the commands of Allah and staying away from the prohibitions of Allah. This puts the iman in the heart of the believer, that Allah is the one who commands, and Allah is the one who prohibits, and Allah is the one that we love, and Allah is the one that we fear. So when a young child is taught about Allah Jalla wa'ala in this manner, he begins to love Allah and fear Allah and hope for what Allah Jalla wa'ala has from that age. So nothing will take him away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. احفظ الله يحفظك, that God, the commands and the prohibitions and the limits set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will protect you subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a believer thinks about just this part of the hadith, he remembers the greatness of Allah Jalla wa'ala, that only Allah deserves to be worshipped. Only Allah deserves to be asked. He remembers the might and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah jalla wa ala says in the Quran, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. That they never gave Allah jalla wa ala their due rights. They never gave Allah jalla wa ala his due rights. وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ When Allah will grasp the entire earth on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ And he will roll up the heavens in his right hand. سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. This is Allah Jalla wa'ala, the one who sets limits. This is Allah Jalla wa'ala, the one who commands and the one who prohibits. And when we understand Allah Jalla wa'ala in this way, then we can do what the anbiya of Allah Jalla wa'ala did in the Quran, as Allah Jalla wa'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ That indeed, they were at the forefront of doing good deeds. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ And they would call upon Allah Jalla wa'ala with love and with hope. And they were from those who feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is how the anbiya of Allah jalla wa ala understood Allah. So they excelled in the acts of ibadah. They excelled when it came to their love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ That those who believe, they love Allah jalla wa ala more than anything. And those who believe, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anything. And those who believe, they rely upon Allah Jalla wa Ala more than anything. So this is what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wanted to teach Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. Ihfadillah. That guard the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah Jalla wa Ala gives us a command, we do the command to the best of our ability. If Allah Jalla wa Ala prohibits us from something, we stay away from it with the best of our ability. If Allah Jalla wa Ala loves something, we become close to it. If Allah Jalla wa Ala hates something, we distance ourselves from it. احفظ الله. That guard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يحفظك. Allah Jalla wa Ala will guard you. What does it mean Allah Jalla wa Ala will guard you? When the one who is guarding the heavens and the earth, who has created them, when the one who says that he is holding the sky above our heads without any pillars, he will guard us subhanahu wa ta'ala, means that he will protect us in this life from any harm. This is harm with regards to our families, with our parents and our children, with harm regards to our wealth and our possessions and our property, with harm with regards to our health and our bodies, with harm with regards to our wealth and our assets. Allah Jalla wa Ala will protect all of this in the dunya. And even more, Allah Jalla wa Ala will then protect our religion, which is even greater, subhanahu wa ta'ala. احفظِ الله يحفظك. If we guard him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will guard us. احفظِ الله تجده تجاهك. And if you guard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find him in front of you. What does it mean, you will find Allah Jalla wa Ala in front of you? This is the specific nearness that Allah Jalla wa Ala has with the believers. That everything we will do will be through the assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the enemy comes in front of us, Allah Jalla wa Ala will be there to take care of them. If any harm comes our way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there to protect us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions in the Quran about the Sahaba, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ When it was said to them that the people have gathered together against you, such a large number have gathered together against you, O companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَخْشَوْهُمْ So be scared of them. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا But their iman only increased. وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ And they said, Allah Jalla wa Ala is sufficient for us, and He will be our protector and our helper. احفظِ اللَّهَ تَجِدْهُ تُجَاهَكَ If you guard the boundaries that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find Allah Jalla wa Ala in front of you. He will have a special mercy that He will give you, a special mercy to those who are close to Him, a special victory to those who are close to Him. He will give you special provisions for those who are close to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ That if you ask, saying this to a young child, to imprint iman into his heart, if you ask, then ask only Allah. And if you seek help, then seek help only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you ask, you only ask Allah, telling this young child that Allah Jalla wa'ala, He is the one who provides. He is the one who gives. He is the one who sustains. He is the one who takes care of His creation. Even if you have the creation in front of you, if Allah doesn't want you to have something, you will not have it. And if everyone wants to prohibit you and prevent you from something, if Allah wants you to have it, you will have it. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ, that if you ask, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ, and if you need help, then only seek help in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala, he said there is a chapter in the Qur'an that summarizes the entire Qur'an. And this is Surah Al-Fatiha. And there is an ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha that summarizes Surah Al-Fatiha. And this is إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, you alone we worship and you alone we ask for help. He said the entire religion of Allah Jalla wa'ala can be found in this verse. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, that you alone we worship and you alone we ask for help. We know that if we worship Allah and we guard the boundaries that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah Jalla wa ala will protect us. Allah Jalla wa ala will help us. Allah Jalla wa ala will defend us and honor us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise our stations in this life and in the next. And He will make our path to Jannah easy for us. And He will give us the blessings of this dunya and the akhirah. إِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. So if you ask, if you seek help, then only seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After imprinting this iman in the heart of this child and in the mind of this child, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to give him an example so he can understand this even better. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa'lam, and know, لو اجتمعت أن الأمة لو اجتمعت على أن ينفعوك بشيء لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ إِلَّا قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. And know that if everyone got together, if all of the nations they got together and they wanted to benefit you in something, if all of the nations, imagine all of the creation of Allah Jalla wa'ala, they got together and they said, we want to help this man. So they all got together and they wanted to help him. They will not be able to help him if Allah Jalla wa'ala decides otherwise. They have nothing. So when the child hears this, and when the slave of Allah Jalla wa'ala hears this, no matter what the creation do to help me, they will not be able to help me. So who should I turn to? I should only turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ, and if the people they got together and they wanted to harm you in something, لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ إِلَّا قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ, they will not be able to harm you in anything except Allah Jalla wa'ala has written it down. Imagine the entire creation wanting harm upon one individual. And they got together and they tried their utmost to harm him. If Allah Jalla wa'ala decreed that they will not be able to harm him, they will not be able to harm him. رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامِ وَجَفَّتِ الصُّحُفِ, and the pens have been lifted and the scrolls have dried. Now this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught this young boy, Abdullah ibn Abbas, who became to be one of the greatest scholars of Islam. He was known as the greatest scholar of tafsir that Islam has ever seen. And he was, a special dua was made by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for him, that Allahumma faqqihhu fi al-deen وَعَلِّمْهُ التَّأْوِيلِ, that oh Allah give him understanding of the religion and give him knowledge of the Qur'an. So he became the Imam of the Mufassirin. But when a believer hears this hadith and he understands these words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart will become attached to Allah Jalla wa ala. If anything good happens to him, he praises Allah and he glorifies Allah. And if anything bad happens to him, he turns to Allah and he asks only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the characteristic of the believer that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to imprint not just in the heart of Abdullah ibn Abbas, but into the heart of everyone from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we hear the name of Allah Jalla wa ala being mentioned, we increase in love for Allah and we also increase in fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Prophet Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions the believers in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, that the believers, when Allah is mentioned in front of them, their hearts begin to tremble. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, and when the verses of Allah are recited to them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, their iman increases. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and they only rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we need to try and achieve, brothers. That when we hear the name of Allah Jalla wa'ala, we begin to fear Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we hear the name of Allah Jalla wa'ala, we think about the boundaries that He has set, and we try and please Him immediately subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why, as we mentioned in the previous khutbah, that when we praise Allah and when we glorify Allah, all of this should prevent us from evil, because we now remember the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. And you alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Allah جل وعلا begins the Quran with this verse. So the believers, when they recite the Quran, they can carry this verse with them from the beginning of the Qur'an to the end of the Qur'an. And they can relate to this verse whenever Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions something in the Qur'an. And Allah Jalla wa'ala gives us great examples of people who guarded the boundaries of Allah Jalla wa'ala. So Allah Jalla wa'ala guarded them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from these people are the greatest prophets that Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions in the Qur'an. We know the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam goes to a disbelieving people, those who are worshipping idols. And at that time he was a young man. He was from his youth. And he went and he destroyed the idols except for one. But when the people gathered together, they said, we are going to throw him into a fire, the lights that no man has seen before. So in the books of tafsir and the books of seerah, it mentions that they kindled and ignited a fire for over a month. And then they took Ibrahim and they couldn't throw him into the fire because of the severe heat that was coming from the fire, they couldn't approach it. So they put him in something that was similar to a catapult and they flung him into the fire. When Ibrahim alayhi salam was in the air, when he was thrown by the disbelievers to the fire, in some reports, it was mentioned that Jibreel alayhi salam came to him. And he said, oh Ibrahim, what do you want me to do for you right now? He said, as for you, then I have no need in you. As for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel, that Allah is sufficient for us, and He is the greatest protector and helper. What did Allah jalla wa ala say? يا نار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم. Oh fire, oh fire, Allah Jalla wa'ala is speaking to. Oh fire, the thing that gives out heat, that burns and destroys things. Oh fire, كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم. Become cool and peaceful for Ibrahim. Allah Jalla wa'ala saw that Ibrahim alayhi salam was guarding the boundaries of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him. So when Ibrahim entered the fire, it became peaceful for him. It became cool for him. He remained in there for a period of time. And the people thought that he was destroyed, that he was burnt, that they had killed him. But he walked away in a greater state than before the fire. Alayhi salam. When Musa alayhi salam was standing in front of the sea, someone who guarded the boundary set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah jalla wa'ala said to him, go and call Fir'aun to la ilaha illallah, the tyrant that Fir'aun was, Musa alayhi salam took up the task. He followed the commands of Allah when the thousands of magicians were there, and it was Musa alone. He followed the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when he came in front of the sea, and there was nowhere for him to go, there were mountains on either side, and the army of Fir'aun was behind, and only the sea was in front. Allah jalla wa ala parted the sea for Musa to walk through. He parted the sea because he took care of his slave, the one who gave him his right, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Yunus alayhi salam, when he was thrown off the boat, so he went into the sea and then swallowed by a whale. They say the stomach of a whale is acidic. Anything that goes inside cannot remain firm. But Allah Jalla wa'ala gave him a place to reside in there. And then Allah Jalla wa'ala brought him back to his people. And he found that they had all become Muslims. This never happened to any prophet before him, that all of the people became Muslims. Only Allah Jalla wa'ala could do this, because Yunus alayhi salam, he guarded the commands of Allah. And he followed the commands of Allah Jalla wa'ala. And he turned to Allah in need. وَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. As Allah Jalla wa'ala, he says, he called to Allah in the darkness, that none has the right to be worshipped except for you. Indeed, I was from the wrongdoers. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains to us how praising Allah and glorifying Allah will give a person relief and victory. Because Allah Jalla wa'ala says in the Quran, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. That if Yunus alayhi salam didn't praise Allah and he didn't glorify Allah, he would have remained in the belly of the whale until the day he was resurrected. احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. That guard the boundaries of Allah and Allah will guard you. Guard the boundaries of Allah and you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of you. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. And if you ask, then ask only from Allah. And if you seek help, then seek help only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows us to have the correct understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we magnify Allah jalla wa ala the way He deserves to be magnified. Yeah. And we praise Him and glorify Him the way He deserves to be praised and glorified. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Rabbana la tu'akhidna in nasina aw akhtana. Rabbana wa la tahmil alayna isran kama hamaltahu ala alladhina min qablina. Rabbana wa la tuhammilna ma la طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. وأذل الشرك والمشركين. ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لهم ناصرا ومعينا ومؤيدا وظهيرا يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. وسلام على المرسلين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.